Hello everyone, good morning. My name is Jatin Arora. I will be your trainer for SAP 1809 Simple Finance S/4HANA. And first of all, I would like to tell you about me, my experience. So I have in total 16 years of experience into SAP and 2 years functional and 14 years in core SAP finance. I have experience in S/4HANA FI, CEO, plus FICO legacy module. I also worked on FSCM, which includes dispute, biller direct, treasury, bank communication management, IHC. I worked on all of that, plus PS module. So it's been around 8 and 9 implementations I've been involved so far. So I started as a unit consultant, then I progressed to team leader, then now I'm working as a overall IT head in one of the esteemed IMC for SAP finance delivery. Okay, so let me first give you an overview what sort of content we will be covering in our sessions and our complete course. So we will start with first introduction. What is S/4HANA? And why we need S/4HANA? Because earlier it was working fine, but then in that case, like why S/4HANA was introduced? Then what sort of changes we have in S/4HANA with respect to SAP ECC or R3, like ledgers, appendix ledgers, currency setup in S/4HANA. Then what is a single source of truth, universal journal, which is one of the major component of Simple Finance, because you must have seen lots of videos on YouTube or Google. So it talks about Universal Journal. So we will discuss about that as well and what sort of benefits that comes with. Customization. So we will start with scratch because I understand like there might be some candidates who don't know anything about SAP. So for them, I don't want to do just 1809 changes because that does not include everything, right? So we will start with scratch. And wherever we have S/4HANA comes with innovations, we will include that as well. So that will comes with complete package. New asset accounting in S/4HANA, which is again a second big component. Changes to controlling. So 1809 only have changes to COPA, account based COPA. Data migration process that will have two components. One is cutover process when we do a fresh implementation or rollouts. And that will also include how do we migrate if we are working on existing SAP setup, that is ECC or lower versions, and now we are migrating to S/4HANA. What sort of process will need to take care? Then it's report changes using S/4HANA accelerated, that is SAP Fiori, how it used to look in ECC, now how does that look and feel changes when we use Simple Finance? Overview of central finance system. So it's just an overview because central finance is a different module altogether. But I'll give you an overview like how that works and what sort of reporting and a bit an idea like what sort of configuration we need to do for central finance achievement. Overview on cash management powered by S/4HANA. This is part of FSCM. So cash management is normally a reporting part, because we don't do any posting in cash management at all. So all of whatever posting we do in treasury module plus BCM plus IHC, all are integrated with cash management for bank reporting. Overview on SAP Fiori. So whatever functional configuration we need to do in S/4HANA Simple Finance, we will complete. And after that, we will give an overview on these three topics. Okay. Now,
Can I ask you a question?
yeah, please.
Yeah, no, hey, Jati, my name is Ajit.
Yeah.
When you say customization changes for DL, so as a part of this course, are we going to cover the configuration for DL, AP, AR, and others, the entire DL FI module, or how is it?
Complete FI module will be covered.
So we'll do all the customizing, right, from SPRO to
Exactly.
everything.
Exactly. So big change. Why I mentioned customization changes for GL? Because we understand like whatever ledgers we are going to create, that is part of GL only, right?
Okay.
So That's the biggest change. APAR stands same, so there is no change in that, and that's why after that we have mentioned new asset accounting. Remains same, but the changes we have in ledgers, GL and asset accounting. But we will cover from scratch, we will cover everything what we have in finance, because we need to configure everything with respect to finance module.
How about CO? You cover CO at all? Part of costing or rental orders or anything at all?
No, that is part of controlling.
So it's not.
Yeah, but we will be covering COPA, what is changed in 1809.
One final question, Jatin.
Yeah.
So there's another thing called central finance. What is the difference between central finance and simple finance?
Yeah. See, simple finance is core finance, SAP module, SAP finance.
World FICO is simple finance.
Yes, right? Correct. Okay. But central finance comes with, that is nothing but reporting, which we talked earlier, we call it consolidation module. Right.
So BCS consolidation, ECCS consolidation.
Exactly. So now we call it central finance because that is powered by S/4HANA, and that is like high-end version of, you can say, BPC. Who know BPC? They can very well configure central finance, and they understand the changes what we do in central finance. That
so
is
are
like.
Are you covering central finance in this course or not?
Sorry.
Central finance, are they going to teach here or only
that? No, that's again a different module. So I'll give you an overview. One session I'll give on central finance, and downline, if you see cash management and SAP Fiori, because these does not come under SAP finance. There's a different certification for all these. But an overview, like what components we have and how, like the basic configuration can be done, and what is the idea behind central finance and all these two, cash management and SAP Fiori.
Thank you.
Yeah, all right. Okay, first let me. So, first of all, I would like to give an basic idea how SAP ECC used to work and what was the need of S/4HANA. So, if you guys are aware, like earlier and now, SAP database or SAP server or database are always three layers. First layer is presentation. Second is application, and the third one is database. So database can be Oracle or Linux. Nowadays it's always Oracle, but earlier it used to use Linux, but that's not the better version. It used to face lots of issues when we use Linux. Okay, and the issue was like, and other was BW. It we normally use in our company, and it was also having same database. So now the issue company was facing was, first of all, performance. I'll give an example, like during month end, when we execute a material, it normally takes around 10 to 15 hours to execute completely. And why we need to do it during month end, because it's having lots of dependencies. Once that is executed, then most of the financial closing activities has to be taken care of, like settlement and all after that. And until unless that is not complete, we need to wait for those cycles to be completed. If system performance is not up to mark, prior steps to this step will be delayed, right? And similarly, we have other steps also in finance which are having a dependency to next step. So that was having huge impact on speed and performance of system. Then OLAP, OLTP, different system. Now, what is OLAP, OLTP? So OLTP means online transaction processing. Online analytical processing. Okay. So ECC, you can say it is OLTP because we are posting transactions which comes from sales, procurement, finance, and other modules. So that's why we call it OLTP, online transaction processing. And now when we talk about BW, we can say it's OLAP, online analytical processing. And now, because we don't post anything in BW, we just create reports and using the data which we receive from ECC. Okay, so ECC, normally we don't normally have batch jobs which runs every day or on ad hoc basis, which copy the data from ACC and move it to BW for moduling. So why we need data in BW? We just take the data from ACC, we start modeling that data, we modify that data, and we create reports for finance, for sales, and planning reports, management reports we do. So when we create that report, that is always Excel based, or we can display that in SAP view also. But why we need Excel based? Because ECC also has standard reports. And the need of Excel was because finance or other people always work good in Excel, and they can apply formulas, they can create pivots, they can create graphs easily. So that's the idea behind creating BW report. That's why we call it analytical. So we can create a different type of management report which is ready to use. So, but earlier in ECC, both system were different. ECC were different and BW different. And if ECC is facing performance issues while fetching the data, and it will delay to sync two systems, ECC and BW, because if this is having performance issues, this will also face performance issues. So that's why all structure will be delayed. So that's the reason there was a need of one system which will have OLAP and OLTP in same box. Okay, so that was again the biggest driver of implementation of S/4HANA. Now, when we talk about S/4HANA, what sort of changes does it have? It is also having presentation and application server that also have database, but database is HANA. Okay, so that's the reason the database changed from Oracle Linux to HANA, that is powered by SAP only. So because of that, now we have one system which is having OLAP and OLTP both. So we have no need to send data to different system to create reports. Okay, and the second benefit is, first is OLAP, OLTP in same box. Second is compressed table structure. Fast reporting. So when I say compressed table structure, so earlier, like I assume like most of you guys worked on SAP, and but we will discuss in detail when we start, because we will be starting in scratch. So for example, in finance, we have n number of table, like hundreds of table in finance, SAP finance. So let's take an example. We have BSEC, we have BKPF, we have BSIS, etc. So whenever we do any transactions in finance, it always saved in some tables based on the nature of any transaction, like these three tables. We have like more than 100 tables in finance, and so do other work streams like sales and all. So because of huge number of tables and huge number of data posting on daily basis, and that was the main reason of dipping down the performance of SAP. So let's take an example of laptop. So we bought a new laptop, and it having a 500 gigabyte drive and around 4 GB RAM, which was earlier. Now it is like more than 8 GB RAM and 1 TB hard drive, that too solid state. So that's how we are improvising system. So SAP also feels like we need to improvise a bit. So they move the database to cloud or on-premise, and they change the database, HANA, from Oracle to Linux. And now the third requirement was to compress the tables. So what sort of compression they have done? They have moved all these hundreds of table in finance. I'm taking an example of finance, and same is happening in other modules also. And they have introduced only one table, that is AC DOCA. Now, whatever documents we are posting, that will be posted to AC DOCA. And it replaced all finance tables. So now it is not wrong if I say only one table will be used for finance postings. So now all the table structure is compressed to one, and that is taking less space, and very much less space than earlier. And because of that, system speed and system performance is increased. Because as soon as we start increasing table space and we start increasing database space, it will impact your performance drastically on daily basis. And because of that, your month end cycle will be very low, because during month end we have to execute lots of transactions, and because of audit also we need to download such data, and when we are downloading that data, the download performance will be very low as well. Okay, so these are the basic things which we have done in S/4HANA. There are more that we will discuss, but these are the some basic components which are introduced in S/4HANA, and because of that performance is very nice. I hope you can see my screen. Okay, I take it as yes. All right, so first release on S/4HANA Simple Finance was introduced in 2014, then in 2015 second version 2.0, then Simple Finance on premise 1503, then S/4HANA Finance denotes applicants. So what they do normally, they introduce the first version in let's say 2014, and they keep introducing new latest version because they keep changing. Even in SAP ECC, when we got ECC, there when we reach ECC 6, and they start increasing patches like EHP 1, 2, 3, and they stopped on EHP 7. Okay, so they keep changing and they keep improvising. Similarly in S/4HANA also. So it started with say 1503. Now we are on 1909. So 1909 also have two changes with respect to finance that we will also cover in our sessions. So we will do 1809 completely, and what sort of changes we have, we will do that also indeed. So we will cover both aspects. So similarly, like later maybe we will have 1910 also, but it's like just released 1909 just released, so the next version might take some time. So if you see the slide, so earlier in legacy database, it used to take just taking example of some good company which is having huge data, so 593 gigabyte of space in traditional database like Oracle or Linux. On HANA, same database, same data reduced down to 118.6 gigabyte. Now when we introduce Simple Finance on S/4HANA, and that also reduced to 42.4 gigabytes. Okay, and now in actual, when we talk about current state, it is now reduced to 8.4 gigabytes because table are compressed and we are now using aggregated data. So data aging, like last 5 years data we are talking about, and 1 year aging frequency. So similarly, what policy we use for archiving. So similarly, now this sort of journey we have completed from 593 gigabyte to 8.4. Okay, so that is how, and that is why system performance is very much increased with this much of data. And earlier why it was not working up to mark, because data was like playing a huge impact on data system performance, because if we have a huge data on our database, then system performance will be very low. So we need to start data archiving, and we need to think about such policies like how to delete unwanted data from directories, because that is also impacting our database, our table space. Okay. So this is an example like a great simplifier of enterprise software. First it was SAP HANA, then they introduced a business warehouse powered by SAP HANA. Then SAP Business Suite powered by, so they are changing the names. Now it is SAP S/4HANA. And major benefit, simplified data model, new user experience, because they have introduced SAP Fiori also. Advanced processing. So why advanced processing? Because we are using one universal journal, and we can post any type of entry. Like we can post to vendors, we can post to customers, we can post to asset accounting, we can post to banking, we can do anything using that single transaction. Choice of deployment. So there are different options for deployment. For example, we can do fresh implementation, and we can do, like, for example, we are working on ECC already. So it's our choice. We can upgrade to S/4HANA, and we don't use new GL. So that's a big component of ECC, new GL. So whether we do use it, we cannot use. We don't want to use it. So that's our choice. But we'll discuss in detail what is new GL and what are its benefit in later sessions. Multi-tenancy. So we have an option of multiple currencies. like one company can have 10 currencies to be used. Okay. So guys, if you have any questions, you are unmuted, you can raise. So there are different deployment.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, please.
So you know, the old BKPF, BSEG, and the old UGL tables, total tables, those tables still exist in S4 or they have been reorganized?
Those are existing. Okay. Those will be updated in the backend. Okay. So when we talk, for example, we need to develop a new, say, new report. We used to use BKPF and BSEG earlier. Now we will be using AC Doka just to reduce the space on these tables. Those will be existing, but we will not be viewing those tables now. But our work, the primary table will be AC Doka only.
Oh.
So
you
the table is still updated, is it?
Sorry?
The table is still updated, you're saying, is it BKPF and BSEG?
Yes.
I don't think
that
so.
Will be updated. Yes, that will be updated in the backend itself. So for foreground, we will not be. Those will be, you can say, obsolete. But that will still exist. We can still view. But as per SAP guideline, but if you view this AC Doka table and then you will see BKPF and BC, you will just feel like this table is having a total of these two tables. Like you can say a total number of transactions, you can see header, you can see the transactions details, like both in one table. You can see
table. What's the name of the table? What's the name of the table?
Sorry?
What's the name of the table? The new table?
It's AC Doka. AC DOCA.
AC Doka. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. So these are various deployment options. On-premise, cloud, and hybrid. So on-premise is like nothing but everything is managed by a company only. So they manage their own servers, everything. And on cloud, we normally go on captive model. We just buy a cloud license from vendor like SAP, HP, IBM. So they are normally selling cloud license nowadays. And hybrid is combined of both, like on-premise and cloud, both. So we'll discuss more in detail, like what are the benefits and what of challenges we face in either of these, like on-premise and cloud, and what is the scalability, like how do we decide? Okay, though it is not relative to finance, but we should know. So we should have some detail insight. Okay. Yeah, this is just a small slide, like on how user experience is enhanced. And if you see this, we can very well use SAP on iPads. And now look and feel is entirely changed. Earlier, we used to see legacy SAP screen. Now it is more of tiles. So if you want to post a journal, we just click on any of the tile shown on this iPad, and it will take us through a journal posting screen. And that is also enhanced. So user experience is very much changed. So it will give you a wow factor, like it looks very nice. Okay. And we do both configuration and postings using this SAP Fiori. But we have an option whether we want SAP Fiori or not, because that depends on what sort of license our company is buying. So that may depend, like your company implement S4HANA Simple Finance first, and they choose to implement Fiori later on. Okay, so that user experience is basically with SAP Fiori. Okay.
The data migration in S4HANA is all in Fiori, right?
No, it's not on Fiori. So we will have a migration cockpit similar to what we used to have in ECC from classic to new GL, and similar in S4HANA Simple Finance also, we have migration cockpit that is upgraded. So whether we have Fiori or not, we will have to use that migration cockpit that will be on SAP screen.
And so we have, are you covering the migration cockpit?
Yes, we will cover.
Okay,
because that's the mandatory step. Without that, we cannot implement anything.
So is it different from Fiori and in the S4HANA,
Fiori is just an optional component just to increase your user experience. So we can have it or we cannot have it. That's the depends. For example, my company is implementing Simple Finance, and they don't have a budget to have Fiori as an add-on, because Fiori can be used by any module. It's not only for finance. Fiori is just increase, like change your user experience. Like it will change the look and feel of your SAP screen. Okay, so it will give you a better view. Similarly, if you see this, I'll have a few more slides to show you, because if you have seen SAP screen earlier, so we will be using the similar SAP screen in Simple Finance on SAP view, but if we have Fiori, your screen will be changed. It's just that, but that's optional. Okay.
What about transactional execution? Because since you told that it is all iconic based, still yeah. We have the transaction list where we execute the transaction, like how we follow
yes.
the ERP.
Yes. So that's again two things. If we have SAP Fiori, we can customize our screen similar to what we do. We create favorites. And if we create favorites, those transactions will appear on these tiles. Say first tile will have post journal. Second tile will have reports to display journal. And third tile will have post, a commitment item. So similarly, in SAP, we will have a list like in purely SAP view. So Fiori will have a different view and SAP will have a different view, but both can be managed, both can be changed, both can be customized. And Fiori can have steps to configure as well. Similarly, when we use SPRO, we will have all the customization step, and similarly, Fiori will have that view also. Say when we want to configure banking, so we will just go to the path, go to the tile in Fiori for banking, and it will give you all the path to be used for banking configuration. Okay.
Just to interrupt, actually, see the banking house bank definition, we can only do it in the Fiori. Actually, we won't be able to do it in the ECC or what do you say, the normal screen.
No, there is a change. So if you want to configure SAP house bank, so either like we have two choice, either we implement two nodes given by SAP, because in S4HANA, FI12, the transaction which we used to use in ACC to create house bank is disabled, is obsolete. Okay. Until we implement two nodes given by SAP. If we implement those nodes, then the new transaction will be enabled. If we don't, then we can use SAP Fiori to create house bank.
Okay,
so SAP Fiori is an option.
Given an option for the Fiori also, correct?
Sorry?
For our training session, we are given access to the Fiori also, correct?
That I think that support guys will add you on. I guess you will be, as far as I know, but they will guide you more. You can check with them.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, but for our sessions, we will be covering everything. Okay. So this is how it looks. So more of the screen, you can like place anything on your screen, and it will look more like it will give you analytical type of reporting. So you can just copy and paste on your email, and that's and the reports are on fly. Only few seconds, report will be on your desktop. SAP Fiori design parroting applies to the entire SAP S/4HANA suite. All new SAP S/4HANA business scenario are delivered in SAP Fiori apps. Example, Simple Finance, Public Cloud Edition. So whatever you can do in SAP, you can do on Fiori as well. So everything is linked. It's not like SAP can do this, but Fiori cannot. It's not like that. It is always 1:1 ratio. But user experience and look and feel is totally different. It is just a wow on Fiori. SAP has a roadmap to leverage Fiori for other important process in S/4HANA. So there might be few changes like coming in with other latest releases by SAP, but that will be more to go. So any questions, guys? So far, this was only slides I have prepared for demo, but there will be a lot to cover in sessions when we start.
So how many sessions are we planning?
It will be basically divided into 45 to 50 hours. So one session I normally take around 1.5 to 2 hours, because I can take for 3 hours also, but that will be more for you guys to practice entire week, because I understand you guys might be working anywhere. So I can give you like 5 to 6 hours per week, but similarly double you need to invest during practice. So I would say like 1.5 to 2 hours sessions, like for 2 sessions per week, and 45 to 50 hours. Or we can split like 1 hour daily So that depends, like how do you need?
This is Monday through Friday.
Sorry?
Is it Monday through Friday?
Yes, this is Monday to Friday, 1 hour daily.
Hello, is it audible?
Yes.
Hello.
Yeah.
What are the FI and CO, the syllabus you are going to cover?
Okay, one second. So it's, So this is the course content. So we will cover complete finance, FI. So CO will be only overview of COPA changes, because that is what is changed in 1809, nothing else. Product costing remains same. And so you have one information. Server access will be provided for 4 months. So you will have 4 months of system, so you can practice whatever we will have covered in sessions throughout 45 to 50 hours. And we will have overview on these three, last three topics, central finance, overview on cash management and SAP Fiori, because those are not SAP FI contents, but we will cover. So we will understand like you should have everything what is part of SAP 1809 S/4HANA. Okay.
The session, we are going with the 1809 only.
No, we will cover 1909 as well, because there are only two changes we will have. So we will cover that as well. So we will do 1809 complete, and whatever changes we have in 1909 with respect to finance, we will do that as well.
Okay. And you told, archiving topics you told, right? When you come, when you said all line item tables is going to eliminate and in future, and it is getting updated as well parallelly as of now.
Yes.
And Ashoka, you will be getting only one liner CEO and FI document. Mm-hmm. So, which is the first priority? You go for the archiving in Ashoka. Either right. I do FI. Parallel, it will go CO also, or CO I need to do separate.
No, it's not separate. Now it is online, so similar to what we do in ACC, but structure is little bit changed. So now we need to create, like for example, the main change in primary cost elements. So earlier we used to create it manually. Now in when we create GL master, at same screen we will create cost elements as well, and even secondary cost elements will be added in FI. So we will discuss more, but there is a lot more to do than finance. So there are many changes, frankly speaking. In
one more question. What about validations and substitutions?
That also we will do. Yeah.
Is there any changes? Because we have been.
There is no change. So it's just like, see, earlier also when we create a substitution validation, so it was just a node on transaction level. So we will have tables automatically added to it. So we will just need to select and build our rules. So when we go into it, we will see like for header, what are the tables available, for line items, what are the tables. We just need to select and build our rule. Okay, so that is the same.
And every day session can be recorded and share the videos to us.
I will need to check with support team. I think yes, recording will be there and it will be sent to you, everyone. So that will be available for you guys to view it later on.
Yeah, because if we not attended, at least we can download.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah, because I know you guys are working, so you might not able to attend every day session. You might need to skip, but recording will be there. You can refer it later on. Should be fine.
Where you were working, sir? How many projects you have in that?
No, I can't disclose, but yeah, I'm working as in finance IT head in one of the good MNC, and taking care of S/4HANA and FSCM module right now.
And material literature, there is no changes, only in COPA as of now.
Yeah, only COPA at the moment, and we will, and I'm again saying again, like whatever changes we have in COPA 1809, we will discuss only that, because that is part of controlling module. So we will just discuss the changes, okay? Because COPA will need complete configuration from sales module. We cannot have it, okay? And from SAP also, COPA is end with different certification. Same for product costing as well. So we'll just discuss the changes we have in COPA.
Heard material literature should be mandatory. We go for S4.
Yeah. That we will discuss. I'm saying, like, since this is just a demo, so we will discuss a lot more things to go. So first session, we will discuss like introduction to SAP HANA, what are the mandatory things and how do we deploy? And because there will be a lot of things to do, start before we start the configuration things, there will be lots of things to clarify the basic stuff. So like whether do we have a new GL or not, it is mandatory for S4 HANA or not. So we will have lots of questions before we start deployment.
Central finance is the separate server or not? It is included as for login.
That is part of S4HANA only. That's a component, but that's a different module. Similarly, like we have a BPC, we had a JVA consolidation module. So that's a upgraded version. So for group reporting, we use.
Okay, thank you.
Controlling module. Presented in this content here, so only those changes are implemented in S4HANA, or you are
so
calling only
for, fix? So for now, it's just changes to controlling for with respect to COPA. Product costing is not yet changed, and in 809, the only changes I see, the only changes were done for primary and secondary cost element, how those were created earlier, and now how those are created now is totally changed. Okay. So for now, only two changes, COPA and LMS.
Okay, are we anticipating any further changes in CO module? Because we see the vision contents be a majority of changes in FI rather than CO.
There might be. So as I said, like they are just changing based on the patches they are implementing, like 1809 has most of the finance, then 1909 only two components. There might be new patches coming in for with latest inversions for controlling module. Even they haven't touched FSCM yet. FSCM is all same. So there might be changes for FSCM. So similarly, they will touch one by one.
Sir, shall we get
master also, because we are using the business partner, correct?
Yes. Business partner we used to have earlier also, but now business partner is totally enhanced. So we will use only business partner. We don't use customer vendors. So business partner will be like customer vendors will be replaced with business partner in a simple finance.
Yeah, correct.
Sir, can we get the syllabus content in detail to our mail address?
Yeah, we will get you that. Yeah, we can send. No issues with that.
Again, one final question. Yep. You will be the only person who will be completing all the chapters till the end, because yes. In the first session we had a person called Daya.
Okay.
So it looks like there is a shuffling.
I will be the one. Yeah, I will be the one who will be teaching you all these topics, and I will be the one who will be sharing your documentation with respect to all this. And there which are not even in this content, like AP, AR, and some sort of banking, because we will be completing complete FI module plus these changes, right? So 45 to 50 hours are quite good enough. Like we will be doing from scratch till end, so everything will be covered.
Okay, are you helping us with the certification clearance and providing us?
Yeah. See, whatever documentation I will share. Whatever documentation I will be share, you can, that will be good content for certification, because certification are itself like coming from the content we are going to do for 1809 or 1909 or earlier. So that will prepare you for that. And you will be having my contact, so we can get in touch base, like if you have any queries or anything, I will be helping you out. No issues with that.
Will you be covering a bit depth in the COPA, because I'm concerned about COPA?
See, whatever, that's what I'm saying, like whatever changes we have in 1809, I will cover.
Okay.
Yeah, but in depth, I don't know what do you mean, because configuration we cannot do, because we have like, if you understand, COPA is having 90% dependency on sales SAP SD module, and we cannot configure that SD. So we can, that, and that's the reason SAP also have three different certification, one for product costing, one for COPA, and one for normal controlling basic. And for finance, we have two two, asset accounting and GL, and other like AP and AR, one for others and one for asset. So because we have huge dependency and we cannot completely configure COPPA individually. So that's
you mean to say each submodule we have a separate certification as of now?
No, for finance it's just two. Asset accounting different and rest others different, but controlling we have three. Controlling
in the management accounting we have a three COPA, product costing and CO, three papers. Yeah.
Correct.
So then okay, if you're saying COPA and what is it like product costing, then the other one is left with the only like a profit center, cost center and anything else. Exactly. In the
exactly you take it right. So cost center accounting that covers assessment distribution cycles, everything.
Assessment cycle and other thing. Okay.
Manual repostings and that is having a lot, like it's not just a simple component. So cost center and profit center is having a lot of things to do.
Because that assessment cycle and other things also like majority should be covered under product costing also.
Yeah, but that is part of cost center accounting. Product costing, yeah, we can do that because most of majority is we are just distributing overhead cost. Execution is done in product costing, but yeah, configuration will be done in cost center and profit center accounting.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Product costing not covered, part of this course.
No. It's not changed. So S/4HANA does not have any changes with respect to product costing yet. That is same.
Yes, sir. Better you can share the syllabus content so
that
will be in detail. Like what under each submodule, what are the topics which we are going to cover?
Right. I will share. You will have it shortly.
We have only weekday classes or weekends also?
You can choose like either weekdays, like Monday to Friday, or either weekends. Because if you have 7 days, then you will be exhausted. You will not get time to practice.
See, I'm looking at the weekend class, but you are saying this course is going to be on Monday to Friday. That's where my worry is actually.
See, in that case, I think the support team will help you, like to choose your correct timing, whether it is weekdays or weekend. So, what choose best, I think you may plan.
Okay. So you are conducting on Monday to Friday, is it?
Sorry?
You are conducting on Monday to Friday, is it, the classes?
No, I can conduct weekdays and weekend both. But what I'm suggesting, one batch, for example, you should attend only either weekdays or weekend. Because 7 days is not possible. Because you will be exhausted totally. When will you practice? Because practice is must.
Yeah, right?
If you're doing weekend, you need to practice during weekend. If you're doing
daily basis?
So daily basis, it will be, I think, 6 to 7 a.m., 1 hour daily, and it is weekend, then I will need to check like what sort of time we are planning.
Server access, they'll be providing, right?
They'll be providing for 4 months.
If you miss the weekday class, can we compensate that with weekend?
You will be having recording for the session you are missed. So you will have that link on your email. So you can just access that link and you can go through the recording and you can very well raise whatever questions you have in the next session. So there is no chance to miss anything because you will have a recording session for everything.
We can download the recordings, right?
Yes. So guys, any further questions or we are good to close?
Yeah, thank you. Your good name?
My name is Jatin.
Okay.
So when are you starting the class now?
So most probably, I think next weekend we are going to commence, or after, like if it is weekdays, I think next week we can start.
Weekdays means Monday or?
Monday to Friday. Weekdays and weekend is Saturday to Sunday only. So next week we can start. in both cases, weekends or weekdays.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, guys, and we'll see when we start the sessions. Meet again. Thank you so much.